My name is Marieke Meusres and I'm a lecturer at the Econometric Institute of Erasmus School of Economics. Right now I'm teaching two courses. The first course is the course Mathematical Methods. It's a course for our econometric students, a first year's course. I will also be involved in the Mathematics 2 course. I will be teaching partly the Mathematics 2 course. This is a first year course for our economics and business economics students. Actually, I teach both courses twice, once for the Dutch group and once for the international group. And besides that, I also work at the Tutor Academy and I do some research. At the Tutor Academy, we are responsible for staffing the tutorials. We do this in cooperation with the course coordinator. So together with them, we have the job interviews. And actually, after that, our main task is to supervise and to guide the teaching assistants. We do this by means of regular tutorial visits, and after that we have individual evaluation meetings with them. Criteria to choose a teaching assistant? Well, first of all, the main criterion is that the student needs to have good grades. This is not the only thing, especially good grades in the course or in the field that this student will be teaching. The motivation should be there. If the student contacts us and applies himself, that is a really big plus. For the rest, I think that the student assistant should be mature. He should be able to take responsibilities and he should take his job very serious, because in the end he is an employee of the university. And besides this, especially when it comes to econometric courses, he should be very precise about notation and precise about what he will be teaching the students. The best thing about my job is I think the contact with the students. I really like teaching. I really like to transfer knowledge to other people. And actually, it always keeps on challenging me to find good ways of explaining difficult materials to our students. When I finished my bachelor, I was actually 20, and I finished my master when I was 21. So I thought that this age would be way too young to go into business. So I decided to continue with another master, a research master. And during this research master, I noticed that I like doing research. And that's why I continued with a PhD, a 3 years PhD position. Actually, this 3 years PhD position, I saw it a bit as a paid continuation of my student life, because I had a lot of freedom and I could really do what I like to do. And after my PhD, I noticed that I wanted to stay in academia. Not with the focus on research, but more with the focus on teaching. And this is how I ended up as a lecturer at Erasmus University. The fun thing about working with students, well, besides the teaching itself, I like to talk with them and also to get to know them a little bit better. And I think that also having contact with the students also keeps me somehow young as well. Memories about my student life. Well, when I look back at my student life, I see a very good time. I really enjoyed my student life. Besides being a hardworking and serious student, and actually I also had quite many side jobs, I think I had plenty of time for funny things like doing sports, playing board games, going for a drink, and a lot more. And what I also liked about the student life is that it is very easy to meet new people and to build a friendship with them. And actually, there was always somebody around in the city center who could have a dinner with me at that evening. I met many friends during that time and I still have a very good friendship with them. My main field of research is cooperative game theory. Cooperative game theory is a mathematical tool to analyze the cooperative behavior between a group of players. I focus mainly on interrelations between cooperative game theory and operations research. What motivates me to do research is that I really love the beauty of mathematics. And next to this, I like to learn new things. I also learn new things with teaching at the university, because I think you can only teach something very well to students if you really understand the material very well. So with teaching I learn a lot as well. But I also learn a lot with doing research, by reading papers, and also by doing research myself.